a safe return from the International Space Station, a new weather satellite launched into orbit, and our next Mars mission moves closer to launch. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. After saying farewell to colleagues aboard the International Space Station are Mark Vandehei and Joe Acaba, along with Russia's Alexander Masurkin, safely returned to Earth on February 27th. The crew's Soyuz spacecraft touched down in Kazakhstan, wrapping up a nearly six-month mission conducting research and operational work in support of the space station.
3, 2, 1. And liftoff.
The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's Geostationary Operational Environmental Satellite S, or GOES-S, launched from Cape Canaveral Air Force Station on March 1st. It will provide faster, more accurate data on wildfires, tropical cyclones, and other hazards affecting the western U.S. and the Pacific Ocean all the way to New Zealand. Our InSight spacecraft was shipped from Lockheed Martin Space in Denver to California's Vandenberg Air Force Base to prepare for its launch to Mars in May. InSight will be the first mission to study the activity deep beneath the Martian surface. It's also the first interplanetary spacecraft to launch from the West Coast facility. NASA gold plating technology used on spacecraft as far back as the 1970s also plays a supporting role at the Academy Awards. The gold plating technique, perfected over many NASA projects by Brooklyn, New York-based Ebner Technology, is used to make the Academy's coveted Oscar statuettes harder, shinier, and more durable than possible with traditional gold plating. The company has provided gold plating for spacecraft that have traveled to Mars, and most recently the James Webb Space Telescope that will launch next year to help us answer questions about our universe. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.